Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome back to Honkai Star Rail. So, tonight we are... Why did I say tonight? I mean, I'm recording at night, but today we are going to do this companion mission that I accidentally started. I don't know whose it is. It's not Asta's. We already did hers. Is it Arlan's?
Can you see the stars from here, too?
Whatever it is, we're about to do it. Oh, there's Peppy.
You're here. This is urgent, so I'll cut to the chase. Arlan's disappeared.
Okay, so I'm guessing it is his. Disappeared?
Yes, I can't find him. He's not answering his messages or calls. In all the time since I took him in, this has never happened.
Have you checked the surveillance cameras?
Of course. I didn't see him. Parts of the surveillance system were destroyed when the Legion invaded. It still hasn't been fully repaired. Maybe he took advantage of a blind spot. It's been 13 hours since he last contacted me. It usually takes less than 13 seconds to reply to my messages. I looked everywhere and couldn't find him, so I checked the security department's work plan records. This is what I found. Look, at his last work objectives entry, of the heart, of the mirror, of the self. It's so strange.
Sure is.
I knew it. You think so too, right? I asked people in the security department, but none of them thought it was concerning. They said stuff like, Brother Arlan is a grown man with his own plans. I couldn't get them to listen at all, so I'm asking you for help.
You don't have any clues. How can I...
I have a secret weapon. Say hello to...
To Peppy?
Peppy!
Peppy! Hi, Peppy!
Mm-hmm. Peppy's my dog. Arlan's looked after him since he was a puppy. They're great friends. Peppy knows Arlan's scent. Maybe he can track him down.
Then get Peppy to find Arlan.
Peppy can't go alone. What if he gets lost too? And I can't go with him. If people see me, the acting lead researcher searching for Arlan, wouldn't that make Arlan look incompetent as head of the security department? Oh, let's go together! Relax. Peppy doesn't bite.
I'm not worried about Peppy biting. Hello, Peppy. Hello.
Sure Arlan was here, Peppy? Weird. Why would he visit this Casanova?
Casanova?
Look at all his fans. Need I say more?
Yeah, Stell, we already know about this dude.
Behold, the winner of the most awesome researcher contest. It's better if I don't show my face. See if you can get some intel out of him.
Fine.
I must confess that I too was terrified. Petrified even. But there remained a light in my heart. A light that led me onward. That light was the happy smiles on all your faces.
Master Capote thinks about me!
It's you! Long time no see. Are you okay? You look troubled. That's quite a wrinkled brow. Now, join the others and listen to me recount the tale of the Legion's invasion. I'm sure your memory of the events will dispel your worries.
You've listened to Capote for a long time, thus gradually forgetting what you're going to ask. Oh god.
The Antimatter Legion barely missed me, and that's when I saw your faces. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't be standing here today.
Long live Master Capote!
Oh my god.
Oh? Still troubled? You must be ill. You look pale and your pupils are gray. That's fine. I, Capote, never waver in my support. I shall double my efforts to heal your heart.
Ugh. Bruh.
The Antimatter Legion barely missed me. And that's when I...
So I have to nod.
Aha! I see you no longer look troubled. There is only one word to describe your expression. Enlightenment. Such is the power of my rhetoric. It creates an energy that uplifts the soul.
You've asked Capote about Arlan.
Arlan? Yes. I know him. After all, my calling is to light up the heart of every person on the space station. As to his current location, then...
You are so annoying, dude.
But I cannot tell.
Insert dramatic pause and sudden drama here.
Everyone knows the most important word in my life is principle. Huh? Without principle, what difference would there be between a person and a mechanical arm?
Wait a minute. Last time he said the most important word in his life was illumination.
We need to update Master Capote's life wiki. This will be version 12.0 of his life keywords.
You've got to be kidding me.
I do not lie. I can tell you that I did indeed meet Arlan recently, and I know where he went. Regrettably, I already swore on my life that I, Capote, would never tell anyone Captain Arlan's secret.
I guess we gotta butter him up.
Seems like you already know what kind of person I am.
Unfortunately.
Captain Arlan had a similar expression to yours when he found me. He was anxious and desired an answer. But answers are not easy to give. Besides, he wanted to master a trial of the heart that would thoroughly change him, and that would be even more difficult. You can't even imagine the difficulty of the trial. I was tired merely from the act of imitating that way of talking with him. Thankfully, he... No more.
His words match Arlan's work plan records. Seems like he does have key information.
You've asked Capote about the trial of the heart.
I didn't say that. Did you mishear it? what I said was, life is a trial, and you need to be true to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So, I know nothing about anything you said about Captain Arlan. I need to head to a meeting now. Can we talk later?
I can't let him get away like this. If he doesn't want to tell me, then...
Tempt him with a promotion.
Don't joke about that. Promotions have a strict assessment process. I did hear that the space station gives special benefits to morally upstanding researchers, but those are just rumors. Even the oldest staff have never witnessed it.
Stop looking down on Master Capote! He's not the kind of person you think he is!
Yes, he is.
Master Capote's Life Wiki, version 4.0. Master Capote doesn't care about rank. Everyone knows that.
Even if you promoted Master Capote to acting lead researcher, he wouldn't tell you about the trial.
Indeed. I won't forsake my precious morality for something so base. How could you think up something so terrible? You're not just lost, my friend. You've completely strayed from the narrow path. I need to give you a thorough education on human ethics. We'll need to sit down and go over it slowly.
No need to bother Master Capote.
Oh,
we'll
goddammit.
Justice for you ourselves.
You've been surrounded by the Master Capote fan club and listen to a frustratingly long lecture, thus gradually forgetting what you're going to ask.
Wow.
Damn it.
Fringe is strong. I need to remember what I came here for.
God damn it.
They went through everything with you? I'm sure you reflected deeply on your actions.
Oh, so deeply.
Well, I'll pretend I never heard the things you said. Think before you act in the future, please. Of course, if you haven't reflected enough, we can always talk more in private. Right now, I need to hurry to a meeting.
I do not like the way he said that.
I can't let him get away like this. If he doesn't want to tell me, then...
Dare to utter such a threat? Listen here. Leaving aside the fact that you don't have the right to dismiss me, I wouldn't yield even if lead researcher Asta... No, if Madame Herta herself commanded me.
You want to put that to the test?
You want to threaten to kill me while you're at it. I said it once and I'll say it again. I will not yield.
Master Capote is so courageous. We're so lucky to be his fans.
Said the exact same thing when he promised Captain Arlan.
Yes, the part about not yielding. It's making me tear up.
I'm gonna print out the transcript of the conversation as soon as I get back today. The fan club needs to recite and memorize it.
Transcript? They've recorded Arlan's conversation with Capote? I didn't think a clue like that would suddenly pop up.
Alright, can you, let me take a look at that transcript
just now.
Hey, you've been talking Master Capote's ear off this whole time. Do you want to join the fan club?
Absolutely the fuck not.
I bet you do. You wouldn't have known about Captain Arlan's meeting with Master Capote unless you had an interest.
You even memorized the internal testing content for version 12.0 of Master Capote's life wiki.
What?
You must be one of those super fans that stayed under the radar. We've been careless.
We're on the same side after all. Here, this is our latest welcome bundle for new members of the fan club. And I'll toss in an updated version of Master Capote's life wiki.
Oh, he looks really cool in the new limited edition snapshots.
Oh, that guy is so annoying.
What's next on the agenda?
Two of them. We've got plenty of clues. I wonder what these two are about. You've told Asta about what just happened and the clues you found. Oh, one of them is about that one mission I was going to do when I triggered this.
Did you have to get that sleazy Capote to help you with a trial?
Let's look at these materials first.
Yeah, I guess that's our starting point.
Read the fan reply card.
This handwriting looks familiar. Oh, is it Arlan's? Against the scorching sun, a beautiful flower will never endure. Within my fair embrace, my love for you is tender and pure. Yeah, so slimy. It does sound like Capote.
The limited edition snapshot.
It's like a candid shot, but surely he knew it was being taken. It's autographed. There's a figure that's not quite in the shot. Oh, is that Arlan?
So Arlan did go to see Professor Capote. This is the evidence.
Read Master Capote's Life Wiki version 12.0.
Even the space station handbook doesn't get updated this frequently. Huh. Is this an audio transcript?
The following is a transcript of a recording. Come on, Captain Arlan, you have to get into the role. I'm sorry, Professor, I just can't think of you as an overbearing boss. Close your eyes and try to feel it. After all, this is your trial of the heart. Listen to my instructions and let's try again. Ahem. Arlan, come to my office. Time waits for no one, and every minute of my time is precious. Yes, sir. Okay, I'm coming over right away. Wrong. Big mistake. Captain Arlan, you can't just be so submissive. If you were tasked with something beyond your scope of work, would you also take off immediately, like you just did? Oh dear. If you want to learn how to handle an overbearing boss, it looks like your heart is going to have to put in some serious training. I see. We have enough clues.
So, trial of the heart means knowing how to deal with an overbearing boss. So that's how Arlan sees me.
Aww. Maybe it isn't about you? Maybe it's about Herta?
I need to talk to him.
No, it's about Asta.
Hurry up and find him. Peppy, it's your turn again.
Where is Peppy? Oh, base zone. That doesn't look good.
That's Dan Hung and the security department staff. There are still remnants of the Antimatter Legion in the space station. Let's go help them.
Hello, Dan Hung.
Survive or be destroyed.
Oh yeah, I got wealth up to level 82. Now I have two level 80 characters. And I'm working on getting his traces leveled up.
Saving me won't earn
eternal sleep is the dead return.
Remember us.
What are you doing here?
I'm here to find a lost friend.
And be careful. There's still Legion remnants in the area. Arlan isn't here right now, so we need to step up the space station security. Spare no effort and stay focused.
Yes, Brother Don Hung.
I'm only helping Arlan. You're here to look for him, right? He's with March.
Oh.
I suggest you don't bother him. He's given himself a personal trial.
Brother Arlan's special trial? He's a man among men, a lion among tigers. He's already reached great heights, but still he wants to improve. That trial, I bet it's even more intense than physical training. And Brother Arlan already challenges himself to the limit in that department. He runs 21,358 meters around the space station every day.
Jeez.
Always so hard on himself.
What kind of trial is it?
I think it must have something to do with the mind. He probably found a waterfall and asked Ms. March to lower the temperature to freezing point. No way. Brother Arlan's trial wouldn't be as simple as just standing under a waterfall. I think he wants to learn fighting skills from Ms. March.
They're not correct, but not wrong either. Arlan came to me to learn how to manage pressure from his boss. So, I sent him to March. If he can manage her, he has nothing to fear.
That's pretty sadistic, Don Hung.
I think Brother Don Hung is pretty smart. Brother Arlan only has one weakness in his armor, but he won't ignore it. He's too awesome for that.
Arlan and I decided to switch our assignments. He went with March to investigate a suspicious crystal, and I've taken up his patrol. That's all.
Did Arlan leave anything with you?
He gave me a pass for access across the space station while on patrol.
I found a broken ceiling tile. This mark? It must be from where Brother Arlan smashed it down.
Move aside. What kind of clue is that?
This floor tile I found is way better. Look at the footprint. It's the right size, not to mention the angle of motion. This is proof of Brother Arlan in combat.
Of the mirror. Did Arlan mention what he meant?
He said he read an anonymous handwritten journal in the space station. It contained 36 different strategies to do with managing pressure from one's boss. It also contained some information on trials. Firstly, trial of the heart. One needs to acknowledge the pressure in one's heart, and only then can one face it. Secondly, trial of the mirror. Like a mirror's reflection, one needs to personally experience the pressure others feel in a job in order to understand it. Lastly, trial of the self. One places oneself within that pressure to complete a transformation. I believe it came to me to complete the trial of the mirror.
So it's not about Asta putting pressure on him so much as he's worried that he's an overbearing boss to the members of the security department? Is that it? Do you know why Arlan is undertaking this trial?
No. He didn't say, and I didn't ask.
Brother Arlan doesn't need a reason to improve himself. You don't understand him at all.
If his goal is to understand the pressure that other people undergo.
Brother Arlan is a fierce fighter with an eye for detail. If you don't understand his reason for doing things, maybe that's because you're too zoomed in.
He's just staying ahead of the game is all. He's the space station's cold-hearted hawk. The security department's alpha wolf.
I don't have any other questions.
If you want to find Arlan, just contact March.
Alright then, let's shoot March a text.
How to manage your boss? Arlan, I'm sorry. I never knew I was giving you so much pressure.
Calm down. Let's look at the clues first.
I need to feel the pressure he's feeling so I can understand what it's all about.
Arlan's ID pass.
On the pass. I got Arlan to look after Peppy because I thought they got along, but is that giving him too much extra pressure? Maybe he printed out Peppy's picture as a way of forcing himself to remember his responsibility.
Broken ceiling tile.
Look how smashed up the ceiling tile is. Arlan must have bottled up his frustration and had no way of releasing it, so he took it out on the monsters.
I'm really not confident that this is about Asta anymore. Honestly, footprint.
Shoe size, all right. And this actually came from a pair of shoes I bought for him. Maybe even these shoes are painful shackles for him.
Let's skip the clues for now.
Yeah, we need to find Arlan quickly. I need to apologize to him in person. Peppy, let's get going.
Supply zone. Huh? What the fuck? Okay, I think that may be tied into, hang on, that's not an event, is it? No. Okay, I think that may be tied into a mission that I haven't done yet. So we're gonna ignore it.
So Peppy can locate March just by looking at a photo of her. Is he really using a scent to track?
I don't know. Let me see. They're there. Well, there's March at least. I don't see Arlan.
What a cute doggy! Oh, you're here too.
Rude! nice of you to acknowledge the canine before me.
Hey, he's a new face and you're not. Huh, this little guy looks familiar. Are you Arlan's puppy? Aw, I'm sorry. Your master isn't here. He's gone off to investigate.
Did he mention anything about a trial?
He kept harping on about Don Hung being a true warrior or something. Oh, he did say that completing an assignment with me would help him complete the final trial. It felt like he learned a lot from me. Then again, everyone has a lot to learn from me.
Why did you split up?
We were investigating suspicious crystals together, but he said it was all pointless if he couldn't transform himself. I could tell he was giving himself a lot of pressure, so I gave him a suggestion. I told him actions speak louder than words when you want to prove yourself. I was just thinking out loud, really. I had no idea what kind of trial he was doing. But when he heard that, he said Mr. Don Hung was right. And then he just left. I took a photo of him. He was doing one of those tough guy walks. Come to think of it, maybe I shouldn't have left him alone. Take me with you if you're going after him.
I don't get to look at it, damn it. Alright. So. Oh, that's pretty far away. Oh, that's all the way over here. Wrong way. I'm gonna have to fight this guy. Okay. Okay. Okay.
The truth of life and death
revealed. We got
in an
this.
Instant. This sanctuary.
Why did it slow down? Oh god, that feels like going through molasses. Oh, you can't auto this? I never realized you couldn't auto your way through these difficult battles.
You know nothing of the survive or be destroyed. There is no other choice. You chose the wrong enemy.
Too late to repent.
I'll see you off.
You are very rude, sir. Please do not target Welt. What did this old man ever do to you? Okay, there we go. Alright. Let me get that. And
I read that Astellaron's internal fluctuations will cause a fragmentum to appear. Did Arlan? Hey, relax. I've seen plenty of Stellarons. It'll be fine. I hope Arlan is safe.
Okay. Down here. Oh, there he is. there's an enemy.
This will strengthen our position.
Pretty big looking enemy too. Let's
Lady Asta, you, why are you all here? I've never seen anything like this before. It looks like some kind of new entity. It must have mutated after being corroded.
Repay. You know nothing of the weight. Be survive or be destroyed. There is no other choice.
Okay, here we go.
Move carefully. The truth of life is.
Oh god, I don't have any of this thing's weaknesses on this team. Whoops.
Everything is ridiculous. Oh, stars, give these trailblazers your blessing.
You chose the wrong enemy. The dead return!
No interest in conflict.
Who invited you?
Let's begin.
Fighting is meaningless.
No manner.
Rude.
Survive or be destroyed. There is no other choice. Receive divinity.
Saving me won't earn
eternal sleep.
Favor.
The dead return.
The truth of life and death.
The sanctuary is but a vision. Break!
Let's begin. I'll see you off.
There we go.
A moment's excitement, nothing more.
Are you okay, my lady? Arlan, I... Lady Asta? Why are you crying? Are you hurt? I'm sorry. Huh? It's all my fault. I've been putting too much on your plate, and that's why you looked up ways to manage the pressure. I honestly didn't realize that these things would bring you so much stress. I just want to say I'm sorry.
My lady, you didn't give me any pressure.
Arlan, you don't need to hide this from me anymore.
Yeah.
She and I know all about the trials you're putting yourself through. If you can't forgive me right now, then I'll reflect further and find a way to prove that I'm willing to change.
But, my lady...
Firstly, your trial of the heart. You went to Professor Capote and asked him to simulate conversations with you so you could better understand your boss. And the evidence is...
Oh, God.
Firstly, your trial of the heart... And the evidence is... Master Capote's Life Wiki version 12.0. This transcript records what you asked Capote to help you with. Here, we can see a bossy manager and you being asked to do things outside of your job description. Clearly, Professor Capote is unlikely to master my speech or mannerisms anytime soon. Oh, but the content is the key here. I am the source of your pressure!
Asta.
My lady, I did speak to Professor Capote, and I did ask him some things, but they had nothing to do with you. I've never experienced any pressure with you.
Oh, Arlan, won't you accept my apology?
Asta, for the love of God.
I'll just have to show you more evidence. We know the essence of your trial of the heart, and we also know that you asked Dunhung to help you complete the trial of the mirror. I'm so sorry, Arlan. Until I spoke with Dunhung, I never realized how much pressure
Asta
was on your shoulders.
Miss, I really don't.
Hold it. I have evidence. Your ID pass.
This isn't just any old station pass, is it, huh?
Asta. It's
a very important photo.
Asta.
A photo of Peppy! Lady Asta, I like Peppy a lot, so I, No, no, Arlan. You don't need to find excuses for your actions.
Asta!
Maybe you've actually convinced yourself. The combination of your simulated conversations with Capote and the entry in your work log about playing holodisc with Peppy, it points to one thing. Me getting you to look after Peppy is the greatest source of your stress.
Asta, oh my fucking god.
Peppy to constantly remind yourself to look after him. I know exactly what message you're trying to drill into yourself by sticking this photo onto your pass. Arlan, taking Peppy out to play is an assignment from lead researcher Asta.
Oh my god.
You better throw that hollow disc like it's a full-on discus. If you spare any effort, Lady Asta will find out and punish you terribly for all eternity. My lady, don't you think that's a long thought to think? Lady Asta, please! I didn't do any of these trials because of you. I always try to complete every assignment you give me, regardless of whether it's within my job description. I really like taking Peppy out to play.
Asta, I don't think Arlan is upset with you.
And Arlan doesn't have any other bosses. Who else would it be? March, he asked to accompany you so he could learn how to manage his stress, right?
What? Arlan wanted to go on assignments just to experience stress? Phew. Good thing I let him go alone. My calming influence would have been extreme.
Yes, definitely.
Guess I made the right decision after all.
Don Hung was right.
What did he say? That I'm good at solving people's problems?
Arlan, all I want you to understand is how sincerely I'm reflecting on my actions. Please, accept my apology. But, my lady... Stop! Arlan, I understood the level of stress you're dealing with as soon as I saw this photo.
Oh my fucking god.
Didn't I take that photo?
I'm always giving you tasks and assignments, but I never actually see how you take to the battlefield. When I saw this photo, when I saw you fighting alone just now, I'm just sorry that I gave you the stress of all my private affairs on top of an already stressful job. Please, forgive me, Arlan.
My lady, I'm very touched, but I started this trial because of Madame Herta.
What?
Whenever she's back on the space station, Madame Herta.
See, that was my original guess. Well, not my original guess. My original guess was Asta, but I also guessed Herta early on. Okay.
Even if I dared to refuse, I wouldn't know how. She's just too overbearing. Whether it's helping her test some new specimen or looking for ancient documents I've never even heard of. Assignments like those were okay before the invasion. But now, I need to focus on clearing out any last traces of the Legion.
Aha! So you're trying to learn how to reject Herta and then put it into practice.
Yes. I found an anonymous handwritten journal while I was cleaning up. It mentioned 36 different strategies for relieving pressure. That's where I read about the trials.
Of the heart, of the mirror, of the self.
Yes. There were detailed notes, so I wanted to give them a try.
Those trials really made Asta worry.
I'm sorry, my lady. I didn't want to bother anyone, so I didn't mention it.
So, you don't feel pressured around me?
I've never felt pressured around you, my lady.
Aww.
All right. It's all a misunderstanding. You two should reflect on your actions, right?
You need to talk to each other more.
Yeah. See, the two of us would never have misunderstandings like this.
Right. Anyways, Don Hung was right.
You keep saying that.
think he should tell you himself.
Thank you for helping Lady Asta. And for coming to find me.
You're welcome. Although if you really want to thank me, let me play Hollow Disc with Peppy, please.
That was a cute little companion, Mr. Oh my god. Ooh, nice. But yeah, that was a cute little companion mission. I enjoyed that. Oh right, I did that earlier. Aha, here it is. So, if anybody knows how to unlock these three, let me know. In any case, I will see you all next time.